Welcome to the Rabid Mining YouTube channel, and today I am showing you my complete installation guide to HiveOS. Now, whether you're an experienced miner trying HiveOS for the first time, or a first-time miner trying anything for the first time, by the time you do get to the end of this video, you will be up and running in HiveOS. Step 1, account creation. For our first step here, you are going to have to register your account. So just click the little sign in button. You can do it in the top right corner in the middle here, and also scroll all the way down and you can see the sign up for free. All three will work for creating your account. Once you click on that, you enter your email address, your login info, and your password that you would like to use. Step 2, create and add worker. Now that we have our account all set up, you can begin working on your farm and your workers. So you're going to go to the plus sign here. You will not have your farm yet. This is what we are making now. So you add your plus, you're going to add your farm, name it whatever you'd like, your time zone, add in any type of auto tags, whatever you want. It doesn't really matter. And then once you do that, you will get come up to your actual farm, which you just created. Click onto your farm, and now we are going to add our worker. Again, we go to the plus sign and add worker. Now here, you're going to put your worker name. For this, we're going to go test video. So I'm going to enter test video. You can enter a password you would like. I just usually do a random one. Tags, again, anything you would like. I'm just going to leave that blank. And this is test worker for video. And then add. Once that is added in, here you'll get your config file and everything. You are going to want to download this config file. Download here, and it will begin downloading. Ultimately, you can go back into this, find your test video worker here, well, any worker, and go into settings, and you can find it again in here. Right there. There's your another rig config, which it'll download it as well if you do lose that screen. Step 3, HiveOS download and flash. So we are going to have to download HiveOS OS now. So to get the operating system, you're back on the HiveOS website, and you're just going to have to click on install here. Now there are two versions. There's the stable version right beside GPU here. So it's HiveOS image for rigs, stable version. You can get the torrent or the zip version. I prefer to use the zip version. And there is also a beta image, which does use the latest drivers and experimental features. So just for a quick example on the difference here, this has newer stuff for like when new cards come out. Say when the 5700 XTs first came out, you did have to run the beta image on them. But since then, things do upgrade and then you transfer over to the stable version. When you're just starting off, depending on your cards, I believe all cards do run today as of the 6000 series and the 3000 series NVIDIA cards. So I do prefer you to use the stable version. So we will be using the stable version. So you just click the zip and it will download the stable version of HiveOS. Once your file is downloaded, then all you gotta do is extract it. After that point here, we do have to get a flashing utility. Now HiveOS does have one on their website to use. I've never really used one. I prefer using Etcher, which I will have a link in the description so you can check that out. So just run, follow that link, go over here and download it, install that, and that will move us to our next step of flashing. For choosing a drive to use with HiveOS, you can either use a standard SSD, about 120 gigabytes or whatnot, or you can use a standard USB stick, 8 gigabytes plus. Either one will work. They both have their pros and cons. The pros with this is it is faster to update, to do any type of driver installs, and this one is a lot slower and do run into more failure problems and have to use more. So for a little bit extra that an SSD is, especially these Kingston ones, I prefer them a lot over top the USB. But again, the choice is yours. You can run HiveOS on either or. If you do choose to go the SSD route there, I do highly recommend getting one of these cables. This will make it a lot easier because for the longest time, I used to rip my computer apart back in there, pull it right apart so I could hook this up to my motherboard or my workstation and flash each time that way. But this will just save you so much time. You just plug this straight into your SSD there and this into your computer and you're good to go. You can also get this fancy USB kit, which does work with this. They come together. This will ultimately plug straight into this little board. And this is for mSATAs, M2s, all sorts of different conversions for SSDs, depending on the motherboard and type of things you do want to use. So this is a nice kit to have handy around for all types of different uses. So our hard drive is now installed into our PC. And if you're using a used one or you do plan on upgrading to a newer stable version as they get released later on. I highly recommend to clean your SSD first, and that's what I'm going to show you here. If it is a brand new SSD straight out of the brand new container, then you can bypass and skip this part. So what we're going to do here is we're going to go to disk part. So disk part right here, we will get this little thing pop up. We can close out the old one and bring up the new one. So now you can see it says disk part. So we're going to list disk. And now this is the list that I have in here. So our SSD is this 111 gigabyte one right here. So we are going to select that disk by going select disk 3. Now it says it is selected. So you're going to want to list disk again just to make sure it's there. So as you can see, it has the little symbol beside disk 3. So now we're just going to click on clean. And there, it's successfully cleaned. So that disk is clean, ready to go. Now we're going to go into Etcher right here. So I'm opening up Etcher. There we go. So we're going to flash from file. We're going to find our file. Mine's already brought up. So that is our HiveOS disk image. We're going to open that. Now we just select our target. Here's our 120 gigabyte Kingston drive. So I'm going to select that. It's going to say flash. Now it's going to give you a warning. This is a pretty big drive because it's not a USB drive that you'd normally do this type of flashing to. So we're just going to make sure you are selecting the right drive and then hit continue. And now we're going to hit OK. And now it does start the flashing process. When your flash actually is completed, you unplug your drive and then plug it back in. And now if you did do the clean install, you will have to bypass this. If not, Hive would have popped up. But as you can see, here we are in format in Hive, and Hive is here, but with no drive letter. So we do have to assign a drive letter. So we're just going to change drive letter here, add a drive letter, assign it, OKG. Now it pops up and we are good. Now we're going to go into there and actually copy our rig config file, which we made earlier. Here I found my rig file that we did make earlier in Hive OS. And now we're just going to go into here, go into our hard drive, and we're going to paste that in. I have a whole bunch, so I am just going to open this and erase the 11 because all it has to be was rig config. So there we go. We are set. You are going to want to click down here. Make sure you do eject it pretty good. That way you don't wreck anything up. Step 4, boot your rig. So you install your USB or SSD, whatever you did use, boot up your rig and you should come in and your rig should be detected. So we're going to click on our farm here. Here we can see our test video rig is active. Now we don't have anything set up yet, so that brings us to our next step. Step 5, flight sheet setup. Okay, so if you're unaware, your flight sheet is like starting your miner. It has the information about your wallet, your address, the pool you're going to mine to, and everything else that pretty much lets you mine. So the first thing you do have to do is set up your wallet. So you're going to go to your wallets here, just click add wallet. As you add more wallets, get a whole bunch of wallets, it's best just to start throwing them all in. That way you do have them. Let's give a quick glimpse here. Here I do have a whole bunch of different wallets set up, like Ethereum. I have an Exodus wallet, a Coinbase wallet, a crypto.com, all sorts of different wallets used for that. But we're just going to do, for an example, how to set up a fresh wallet. So we're going to pick our coin, or we're going to go Ethereum here. We're going to enter our wallet address. So I copied mine. That's your wallet, whatever your address is. You're going to name it whatever you want. So again, test video wallet is what we're going to use. And your source, you can use like a broker, so you have real-time thing. I don't ever use any of this type of stuff, so we're just going to go create. So our wallet is set up. So next up, we are going to have to set up our flight sheet. So again, we're just going to pick our coin. We're going to go Ethereum. Now your wallet is the one you have set up. I have multiples, but we are using the one we just did, which is test video. Now your pool. Majority of all the major pools are in here. So like you have your Ethermine right there. You have pretty much everything depending on the pool. So I am going to use Flexpool because that is what I mostly do mine to. So Flexpool, and then it'll just bring up what exactly you want to use. You want to pick the closest one to you. So United States West, I'm in the western part of Canada. So that's what I will use. And then depending on your card, depends what you use. Now for NVIDIA, I recommend T-Rex Miner. And if you're using AMD, I recommend using Team Red Miner. So this is a 3080 card. So that is NVIDIA. T-Rex, and then you just name your flight sheet whatever you want. So again, I'm going to go test video, and then we're going to create our flight sheet, and everything is set to go. So our test video flight sheet is right here. Step 6, basic overclocking. Before we do start mining, we are going to have to set some overclock settings, or you'll just be using way too much power, and yeah, it'd just be bad. So we're going to click on our rig. We're going to click on the little symbol here that looks like a speedometer. And here you can see all your where you'd enter all your overclock settings. Now, if you're unsure what to use for your card, you can just pick your coin here, and it has a list of overclock settings that other people are using. Now, I do know what I am using, so I'm just going to plug those in right quick and kind of go over everything. So there is an absolute core clock. As you saw, some people are using like -200. So that would be like your afterburner settings and Windows -200. Minus whatever, plus 200, but we can do absolute core clock, which is 500 or over. We'll tell you, we'll give you a set your core and lock it to that. So that is, I set mine to 1040. Here we have a value. So I'm going to go, what was mine? 2400. Now, the thing to know about memory overclocks, which I am going to show you right quick here. So on your memory, when it comes to NVIDIA cards, you actually double it from what you do use in Windows. So if you're saying you're running 1200 memory in Windows, you're gonna need 2400 in Hive OS. Now, with the 5700 XT cards and the 5600 XT, so with those cards, you are gonna divide it by two. So as you can see here, I'm running 912 memory. So that is like 1824. So 9 times 12 is 1824. So that's what your memory would be in here. And again, NVIDIA cards are 2300. Now, if you're using Polaris cards, you keep your memory the same. So here I'm running 2070. So you got to keep an eye out what you actually got to use. When you actually go in here, though, it does tell you. So if we go to our memory clock, core clock, memory clock, now it doesn't say that little pop-up anymore for it, so I'm not sure why. But if we go to NVIDIA cards, you can see here where it says double it. So example, 800 megahertz here should be 600 in HiveOS. But again, it used to say that for the AMD cards, but right now it is not for some reason. Now it is. I don't know what's going on here. So here you go for, well, that's the core voltage. So yeah, the memory clock is not there. I do not know what is going on, but just keep that in mind. 5700 XTs, 5600 XTs, these style cards here, they all are divided by two to get their memory, and the NVIDIA cards are times two of their Windows counterpart, and the Polaris cards, they are at the memory that they run at, so 2070 2070. So keep that in eye when overclocking your actual card. I punched in my overclock settings. I do want to also point out your power limit. So here it's in watts, not in percentages like Afterburner would be. So here I am putting in 224 for my actual power limit. 80% fans is what I run, 1040 absolute core, and 2400 on the memory. I think actually I run 1070, so maybe I'll just run to that. I believe I did need 1070 actually. So this is our settings. Now, to actually start mining, you just go to your flight sheet, you go to the one you just created. So we are looking for my actual flight sheet, which was for the test video, if I can find it anywhere. Now I lost it, I don't know where it went. Oh, I did put the little, so right there, test video F, everything set to go. You hit the little rocket ship, which is to the moon, hit apply, and you're good to go. Close everything out, overview, and we'll let this hash for a little while just so we can see that it is working. Step 7, SSH into your rigs. We are up and mining, it's looking good. 100.3 mega hash on this 3080. Now, if you ever do want to upgrade your NVIDIA drivers or just check out your miner and how it's doing, you are going to have to SSH in if you do not actually have a keyboard or anything plugged in. So you can do this from either your cell phone or whatever, depending on what you want to use. So you run in here. Default is user and password is 1. It's recommended to change that after you do this. So now this brings us to our actual screen. So all you got to do is type in miner and that'll bring you to your miner screen. Now, if you're running multiple miners, which we'll look at in a different video as more advanced type of flight sheets and overclocking, then you are going to want to put an MOTD and watch. And that will bring up the same screen, but you will have a log and you can swap between different miners and different flight sheets that are happening on the same rig, depending if you're CPU mining, GPU mining with different cards and different coins all on one rig doing all sorts of separate stuff. Again, that is in a different video. We'll get into that type of stuff some other time. This is just some basic installation guides. So this is how you actually see your miner at work here. Step 8. Hive OS pricing. So there's a lot of confusion going on with the pricing of Hive OS. So I'm going to try to explain to you how it actually kind of works out. So you can have up to 4 rigs. Now a rig is a motherboard and system, and it doesn't matter how many cards you can fit on that motherboard. One rig is its motherboard, CPU, and everything. So if you have a 19 GPU motherboard, that is one rig loaded up with 19 GPUs. So you're allowed 4 complete rigs. for free. Now, if you do mine Ethereum or Ethereum Classic, you do only get one rig free unless you mine to the HiveOS pool. Now, if you mine to the HiveOS pool, then you do not have to pay for any rigs. But if you are only mining, say, one rig on Ethereum and three other coins like Ravencoin, Conflux, and whatnot, all four rigs will be free to any pool you want. It is only when you start mining Ethereum that you're only allowed one free rig. And then every other rig you will have to pay for unless you are mining on the HiveOS pool for up to four rigs free. Once you hit five rigs, it doesn't matter what you do. You have to pay for them no matter what. So I hope that kind of clears some stuff up for you guys. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And we'll get into some more advanced flight sheets and overclocking later on in a future video. So you should be up and running in HiveOS by now. And if not, let me know in the comments. Let me know what you thought about this video, if it helped you out at all. And any other good stuff that goes along with it. So thanks for watching, guys. And Rabid out. Thanks for watching this video, guys. If you enjoyed this video, please consider watching one of these other videos, hitting that subscribe button, hitting that like button. We do a live stream every Sunday, and Discord link is in the description as well. Thanks, everybody, again, and Rabid out.